It's so risky.
Yeah, well, you know me, Valerie Jacobs, thrill seeker.
Bit different when you end up inside as a result.
Yeah, well, I've realised that.
Did the other women know you know me?
That girl, Patty, realised when I came in.
Yes, well, I'd keep it very quiet. Just for your own sake.
Yeah, well, things have already been said.
Just be careful.
I will. Thanks, Colleen. Knowing you're here makes it a hell of a lot easier.
If you upset the other women, there is nothing I can do.
What sort of friends did you say you two
were? That's enough, Gaffney. Get in. You too.
Are you going to take me back to the others now?
No, you'll be staying here until the morning, Andy.
I guess I better make the most of tonight, then.
Look, Andy, I'm trying to organise a transfer for you. You could be going to a prison farm in the morning.
But it's not certain yet.
No. Look, Andy, I thought things would settle down for you eventually here.
Yeah, sure.
Thought if I kept an eye on you, everything would be all right.
Oh, great. You're only here 8 hours a day. What did you think could happen for the other 16?
Look, Hudson, you're still a prisoner here. Don't forget that. I'm doing my best to help you. If you talk like that to the rest of the staff, you'll go and report and you'll never get out of here and there won't be a damn thing I can do about it.
Okay, okay. I'm sorry. Well, do you think you can swing it?
There's a good chance.
Thanks. Have you seen Patty?
Mm-hmm.
How is she?
Worried. I'll let you know about the transfer.
About that, Meg. Got caught on the phone.
Don't you worry. Was it Patrick?
Yeah. I had a chance to talk to Jennifer and Robert. They are having a wonderful time. They wished I was there, though.
Never hurts a mum's ego, does it?
Oh, it certainly doesn't.
Did you tell Patrick about Valerie Jacobs?
Yes, I mentioned her.
And?
He said to say hello from him. I don't know, Meg. Can't understand it. I had a talk to her before. She doesn't seem to have changed at all.
Oh, is that good or bad?
I don't know. Just let me know how much I've got, I suppose.
Look, if you're going to start feeling sorry for yourself, you can eat on your own.
Sorry.
Come on. It's time we weren't here. Let's go and have a meal.
Right.
Come on, ladies, move it if you want your breakfast.
Oh, we're going as fast as we can. You try sleeping with 8 women and see how much rest you get. Dirty buggers.
Come on, we haven't got all day. Just a minute, Lawson. I just thought you might like to know that Andy's being transferred to a prison farm.
Oh, when?
Later this morning.
Was that your idea?
Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
Hey, Mr. Carson, we going to see Chris MB at breakfast or not?
No, you're not.
Why not? What happened?
They're both in solitary.
What for?
Well, I may as well tell you before the rumours get out of hand. Smith and Latham are being charged with arson and murder.
On what evidence?
Well, a confession from both of them was enough to convince the police.
Confession? Are you joking?
You asked and so I told you. Now, come on, move it.
Sorry, I'm late.
It's okay. Look, I've told the women about Smith and Latham.
Any trouble?
They're not happy, but no problems so far.
Good. Has Sergeant Farmer been in yet?
No, he hasn't. I'll leave you to it, eh?
Hey, Mrs. Powell, how long are you going to keep me and Chrissy locked up?
Well, it's their fault that you're all living in these conditions. So how long do you think they should get?
Ugh, this stuff's awful.
No one's died from prison food so far.
Oh, that surprises me. I don't know how anyone's supposed to survive under these conditions.
You've been inside 5 minutes, Jacobs. I wouldn't start complaining.
What's wrong, Colleen? I just meant that...
I know what you meant. And the name is Mrs. Powell. If you can remember that, it'll make your time here a little bit shorter. Now stop complaining and get on with your breakfast.
My love, seems as though your old mate's forgotten what buddies you used to be.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
Well, remember, in here, a screw's a screw. We're only the prisoners. You're one of us now.
Well, I thought having a friend inside would be an advantage.
Oh, not in here. You stick with us and then you'll be all right. I'll spread the word around that they're to lay off you.
Thanks.
Annie's gone yet, love?
They're hardly going to tell me, are they?
Suppose not. I had a chat to that Valerie Jacobs.
Your pals, mate?
Ex-mate. She's
come on, ladies,
right.
Make the most of it.
Off.
The men are going to use the yard this afternoon.
What are we coming out here for?
Thought you might like one last look at the place, Hudson.
I think I remember what it looks like, sir.
Come on, you won't have too long. Might interrupt the exercise period, Mrs. Morris. Hudson will be leaving in a minute, and I thought we might as well wait out here while reception's being cleared.
Turn up for the books?
Oh, shut up, Marty. Come on. Leave him alone.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. How about you?
Okay, I guess.
I shouldn't have got you mixed up in all this, Patty.
Oh, look, it's not your fault, the way things turned out.
Yeah, but I shouldn't have come and seen you in the first place.
No, I'm glad you did. Wouldn't want you going to anyone else.
I'm being transferred.
Yeah, I know. Well, at least you're getting out of here. Oh, it'll be better, Andy.
Yeah.
Hudson.
Bye.
See you later.
These are Hudson's transfer papers. Take him from here, will you?
Mr. Carson. Thank you.